Himesh Patel is the best singer.
Yeah, I'm not disagreeing.
Hi, I'm Dan Levy, and I play Mark in Good Grief.
He also wrote it and directed it.
And we are going to watch and react to some scenes from the movie. I like to karaoke a lot, yeah. Can I sing TBD?
All the things I've said in songs, all the purple prose you bought for me.
What needs to be understood here is that you can't play music while you're singing for editing purposes. So we all had to just sing a cappella, and then the music came in after.
That I forgot about
is
that.
Acting. There are these like lovely moments that Himesh gives in this, like, is he inebriated or is there something more? It like rides that line so beautifully.
Wouldn't you love someone to look at you like that?
Well, I'd pay for someone to look at me at that point like that.
Yeah. You did, you paid me.
I paid Himesh.
That's the only reason.
It's the only reason why I made the movie.
Well, it's 2 a.m., which means that my husband officially died a year ago today. Such a meticulous person, he left behind one hell of a mess.
We didn't drink, did we? No. Because you, at one point, when we came back to the table after the second round, and I remember you asking, like, is it enough? Is it too much?
Yeah.
Trying to withhold as much as you possibly can. I had talked about working with Catherine O'Hara, who I think, in the history of film, is the single greatest drunk on camera. And she said, drunk people don't want other people to know that they're drunk. And that is sage advice.
So brilliant.
I don't want to say, I don't want to fight another day.
Himesh Patel is the best singer of all of us.
Clearly.
He's not disagreeing.
Yeah, I'm not disagreeing. But also, you know, I was just coming out the other end of a horrible illness, which left my voice completely wrecked.
Oh, yeah, you're very ill, yeah.
Which but it
ideal.
Sounds great, actually, in the scene, though. I chose the songs. They are songs that I have sung in karaoke with my own friends.
The sentimental things I'd write never meant that much to me.
I loved this album. I love Elton John. It wasn't until like actually getting up and performing it that he, I think, started to feel those like pangs of the loss.
You may not believe it, but I don't believe in miracles anymore.
I think we nailed a night out for me with some friends.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's one of my favorite bits in the whole film.
The authenticity of the karaoke experience was actually really important to me, because even down to putting those little hats on the microphones, I made it a specific request to put the hats on because that's very real. All of these actors instantly bonded with each other, and there was it was such a joy to shoot with everybody.
I think it's the magic of Dan's casting, to be quite honest.
And then the magic of karaoke.
Okay, we're on the Ferris wheel. Can you tell us what's going on?
Jesus, Thomas, you're intense.
This is a very real location, and we are very much on a Ferris wheel in the middle of Paris.
With loads of people just on a Ferris wheel in Paris.
With actual tourists, like, riding it with us. So it was a very renegade scene to shoot. There's nowhere to hide, and so the truth has to come out.
I think Sophie's the kind of girl who always has her eye on an exit, wherever, whatever room she's in. So this is the ideal place for her pals to get her.
Terrence got tired of waiting for me to wake the fuck up.
Essentially what it is what this trip is an opportunity to be really, really, like, properly honest with one another and with oneself.
All this time I thought Terrence was too safe for me. But he wasn't safe.
She's having this sort of experience of this sort of exorcism experience, and she's being unburdened.
And that's the part I wasn't getting.
This is now a holding space for her to get everything out.
I'm a 35-year-old woman who had a good man and loved her, and I chose a bus stop.
We've all been there, haven't we?
Every couple years.
If it makes you feel any better, I don't think anyone actually has their shit together.
Okay, that's where I disagree.
Yes, I love that turn when you're like, go on then, what is it?
I think people can have their shit together, and live lives that aren't a total mess.
I love this whole scene, but that moment of him going, actually, no, I disagree, I think it's something that he's not brought himself to do before. And I think because he's maybe reached his nth degree of patience, and I think it just comes tumbling out. This is kind of, you know, this moment where he can't hold on to it anymore. He has to be completely blatantly honest with them.
It costs him being her friend. And it costs people to be our friends sometimes, and sometimes those people need to know.
And I think it's what's keeping you both from realizing your behavior has hurt people.
Okay, is this because I left early last night?
Can we get off this thing?
It was really fun to write this scene and force them to be cracked open. And then, you know, you wrap it up with the Ferris wheel going back through the turnstile.
Can we do that again?
And that's life, you know? Thank you so much for watching us watch scenes from Good Grief. Now it's probably best if you go watch it, only on Netflix.